Hi students, coming to our next topic, that is concurrency control. So before going to know about the concurrency control, let us see what is a concurrency. Okay, so let us see what are the advantages in concurrency, then we will go for the concurrency control. Okay, so actually concurrency is nothing but executing multiple transactions at a time. Executing multiple transactions at a time, you call it as a concurrency. So why we required concurrency? Why concurrency is required in database? So what is the use of using concurrency in database? Okay, only single instruction can execute, single transactions can execute at a time. Okay, after the completion of one transaction, you can enter into another transaction by following the ACID properties. Then why we are going for concurrencies in database? So if you take the ATM machine, suppose. Okay, so if you take an ATM machine, that is SBI bank, related to SBI bank. Suppose one person is withdrawing money in one of the ATM bank. Okay, if you are not using the concurrency, so the person, if he is using the ATM by withdrawing the money, after the completion of his work only, another person can withdraw the money in another ATM. Okay. Means one after another. So if we without concurrency. Okay, so then wastage of time is more, because so many people are accessing the ATMs of the same bank at the same time in different places. If they wait that much of time, it is wastage of time will be more. So for that reasons, we are going for the concurrency. Okay, you can take another examples for railway reservations. Okay, in the railway reservations also, if you are accessing the Tatkal tickets, okay, if you are accessing the Tatkal tickets at the at that particular time, so many people are accessing at a time. Okay, so many people are accessing the Tatkal at same time. Okay, so in that case also the concurrency is important, because it is executing multiple transactions, different people are executing at the same time, accessing the same portal at the same at a same time. Okay, so here one thing is, whatever the transaction is doing by single person, they thought that those transaction will be in isolation. Okay, means whatever the transaction he is doing, the person that thinks, I am the only person who accessing this railway reservation, because he is having that much of features, like he can access, he can book the ticket. Okay, so this is why we are using the concurrency in database. What are the advantages of using these concurrencies in database? Advantages. Okay, so the advantage is, the waiting time will be decreased, response time will decrease, resource utilization. So many people can utilize the same resource. So resource utilization may increase, efficiency will be increased. The system performance and efficiency will increase. So these are the advantages of using concurrency. So even though these many of advantages will be there, why we are controlling the concurrency? Okay, so what is the problem that is raising in using the concurrency control? So here you have to be note that simultaneous execution of transactions over a shared database can create several data integrity and constraint problems. Several data, integrity and consistency problems. Okay, so even though you are having so much of advantages by using the concurrency, the simultaneous execution of transactions, over a shared database, a single database is there. Suppose the database is SBI database. Simultaneous execution, so many people are withdrawing the money at the same time in the shared database, can create several data integrity and consistency problems will be there. So what are those problems? Even though it is executing fasting, the response time is decreased, resource utilization is more, even though those many of advantages, here some integrity and consistency problems will be there by using the concurrency. So the main problems of using this are, there are three main problems will be there. The three main problems are, the first one is lost updates. So updates will be lost. Uncommitted data. Inconsistent retrievals. Okay. So these are the three problems that are facing the concurrency control: lost updates, uncommitted data, inconsistent retrievals. So let us see the conflicts that are arised in the serializability of a transaction. Conflicts. So the conflicts are the write-write conflicts, serializability of transaction. So let us see what are the conflicts that are occurred in the serializability of a transaction. So first, what is the serializability? So serializability or schedule is nothing but a schedule that is equivalent to some serial execution of transactions. You call it as a serializability. So that you call it as serializability. So let us take first conflict in concurrency control. So the first conflict is reading uncommitted data. So you call it as WR conflict. You call it as also as a dirty read. So the another name for the reading uncommitted data is dirty read. So reading uncommitted data, that is WR write read conflict, you call it as a dirty read. So let us see what is this reading uncommitted data. Let us take two transactions, T1 and T2. First, read A value. Suppose A starting, it should be 5. Read A value and increment A by 1. Now the A becomes 6 and stored in, and you are writing the A value. Okay. So A plus 1 and you are writing the A value. Means it's committed. Read A, not committed, it is written. Read A, write A, and these values will be stored in local buffer. Now coming to the transaction T2, what it does, it read A. So whenever the T2 transaction is reading A, instead of 5, it reads the 6 value. After reading, it just commit. Okay. And again, the T1 is still incomplete. It reads the B value and it writes the B value, and it, suppose it is abort. Okay, let us take, so this is the example, T1, T2 or the two transactions, Okay, so first it reads the A value, that is the 5 value, and it is incremented by 1 and it write the value. Now the value A is 6. So after completing the T1 transaction, T2 is reading again the A value. So now it is reading 6 instead of 5. Okay, and it commits the program. So this you call it as a dirty read. Why you call it as a dirty read? Because without committing the it is reading the uncommitted data. In T1 you are not still committed. So it just we return the value in the local buffer. So just stored in the buffer. Okay, so it is stored in the buffer, it is not committed, mean it is not updated in the database. Even though it is not updated in the database, it reading the value whatever it is there in the local buffer, local memory. Okay, now the value here is a 6. So this is the problem. You call it as a dirty read, reading uncommitted data. It is here, it is uncommitted data. The problem here is T2 read a value which is not committed. Okay, so after, even though it is not committed, it reads a value. So after the reading, the value here is a 6 and it is committed. Committed means the value 6 is saved in the database, the original database. It moves from local buffer to the main memory, the database. Okay, so now the T1 transaction still it is not completed. It is reading value B and it is writing B and it is aborted. Whenever the T1 transaction is aborted, okay, so it goes up. Okay, it goes up means all the transactions whatever it is done or failed, it remains unchanged. Okay, the transaction means it is rollback. So whenever it is condition is aborted means all the transactions were done up to now, A5, 6, all the transactions done up to now will be aborted, will be rollback, and again the values whatever there in the previous will be saved. That is now the A is 5. Okay, so now here see the T1 transaction A is 5 and here the T2 transaction A is 6. So this is a conflict, write read conflicts. So this is a reading uncommitted data. So whenever the data that is read which is uncommitted, that here the problem will arise. Okay, so if suppose this transaction is going like that without aborted, then no problem will occur. So the value already here is also updated to 6 and here is also updated to 6, no problem, no conflicts will be there at the side of the database. So whenever the transaction T1 is aborted, here the problem arises. So whenever it is aborted, it remains the previous value, only the 5 value, but here it is a 6 value. Okay, so this is one of the conflict, that is a reading uncommitted data. So let us see then another conflict. So the second one is unrepeatable read. So unrepeatable read means read write conflict. So the next conflict is unrepeatable read. So here unrepeatable read means suppose take two transactions T1 and T2. First it reads the value of A. So A is starting, it should be 10. So it updated to means A plus 5. So and write the it is updated. So now the A is, so just take read the value of A, that is a 10. So T2 is also reading the value, that is also 10. Okay, so after that it updates the value to plus 5, A plus 5, and write the value. Now the A is 15. Write A. Now the A is 15. Okay, wait. Let us see first. T1, T2. Read A. A value is 10. Okay, again it reads the value in T2 transaction, that A value is 10. Okay, so after that it writes A value. Okay, A value, it is write the value of A. So, and then it again writes the value of A in, that is 15, means it is updated. So here it is A plus 5. So after that it is writing the value of A, it is 5. So before, and then it is committed. So now here the value is 15, but here in this transaction it is 10, not, it is just simply reading, not writing. So here this value is 10 and here this value is 15. Let us see again. So this is the T1 transaction and this is T2 transaction. First reading the value of A, that is A is equal to 10. Okay, now the A value is 10. After that again T2 is also reading the same value, because I didn't write anything, so read A, the same value is 10. Okay, so after that it is writing A, T1 is writing A, after updation A plus 5, now the value here is 15. Okay, so now the T2 is again reading A, it is not writing, reading A, what value it reads, so whatever the previous is updated, so write A, so that 15 will be read by T2. So here the conflict arises, that is a read-write conflicts, means a confusion is arise in the T2 transaction. A confusion is arise in the T2 transaction. Means why two values are there for A? So A is 10, again A is 15. Now what value I have to be write? What value the T2 has to be stored in the database? What value it has to be committed? So that is a problem. You call it as a unrepeatable read. So this you call it as unrepeatable read. Read-write conflicts. So according to transaction, it thinks that it is in isolation. Means only that transaction is one who is executing at present. Okay. So this is the unrepeatable read. So let us take the third conflict. So what is the third conflict? Lost update. Lost updated. That is write-write conflict. You call it as a write-write conflict. So let us see what is this lost update write-write conflict. So let us take the again the two transactions T1 and T2. So first it reads the value of A. A starting is 10. Okay. Now increment the A value by 1. Okay. Now write the value. Now A becomes 11. Okay. So in the T2 at the same time it is writing A. Without reading it, just simply writing A. So you call it as a blind write. Means whatever the value that is there in the T1, that simply it is writing the A value. Okay. So, and it is writing the A value, whatever it may be, and it writes that value and make it as a 60. Okay. So 60, and it should be committed. Let us think that T1 is reading one value 10 and it incremented by one value and it is making as write A. Now the A is 11. So T2 is something is it's reading in somewhere in the value and it is writing that, updating that value by making it as a 60. And it is committed. Okay, so after that here also the T1 transaction is also committed. But see here the conflicts. In the T1 transaction, the value is 11. Okay, so whereas in the value is 11 and whereas in T2 transaction, the value is 60. Okay, so this you call it as a lost updated write-write conflict. This write and this write, both writes will be conflicted. Okay. So these are the three concurrency control, the conflicts that are raised while you are transferring this data in serializability transactions. Okay. The first one is reading uncommitted data. You call it as a dirty read. And second is unrepeatable read and lost updated, write-write conflict. Thank you.